YouTube, if you subscribe, and invite them to the remaining social networks, CB6.King. And today, as you saw in the title, we're going back to Battlestar Galactica Deadlock. And today, we're going to check out the reinforcement pack. Some nice new ships are entering the fray. Neat. So today, we're going to check them out. Oh, that's new. I don't like the other ones. Still, the maximum is 8k. Come on. You make me face over 10,000 words in the bloody campaign. Have the decency of letting me play with all the big toys as well. Okay, Dark Nebula. Yeah, it's suiting enough. Actually, I like this one. Okay, proceed. And it's time to make some new fleets. As you can see, I've been playing around with this for a while now. Anyway, continue. Oop. My bad. Mind if I wait? Create a new one? Come on, new one. So, let's see. The new toys. Atlas, Ranger, Janus. Janus, heavy cruiser, many power during the latest stages of war between Vergan and Leonis. Heron plate provided with no staying power to remain relevant in modern warfare. Although its older fire control system, I'm good enough to compare it to more modern cruisers. And then, memory. First, we have the Berserker. Berserker, class carrier. Fast, effective, force multiplier. Carrier did not tend to survive prolonged engagement by itself, however. When supported by a Battlestar or a Strike Group, can provide powerful complementary fire support. So basically, this is a tiny animate. Tiny adamant indeed. So, I'm going to make a battle group around these guys. Okay, let's see. Proximity mines, abuser, EMP mine, let's see. Okay, let's see. Four is going to be torpedoes. The other two are going to be nukes, because come on! Okay, now. The mandatory Jupiter class. Right in the middle. Then I don't think I got to show this the Atlas in the last play, so here it is. And let's see, what do I want? Did I end up using a Minotaur? I don't think so, I did. Anyway, let's see. You two to the back, since you're, well, you know, not all powerful. And the second Atlas. We have two Atlas carriers, one Battlestar, Jupiter class. This guy, the Atlas carrier, the Janus cruiser at the front, the big bruiser, and the OP God of War Battlestar. So let's see. Everybody, Mark IIs. You know, if it is the Chief's ships, it would be awesome if you could just build an enormous squadron of them and see how it went, how it would go. So. Oh, right. I forgot to name it. Okay, come on your feet. Two. Yeah, I know. Oh, the creativity. Save. Confirm. Okay, create new. Summons. Okay, let's see. Okay. Yeah, the Battlestar, the Cerberus, yeah, the Provost, I think this is the new one. Let me see. Yep, I'd say this is the new one. Okay, Provost is the cruiser. Basically, this is the Nemesis' younger, stronger, and more badass big bro. Yeah. Okay, missile tubes, confirm. And also has fighters. The other one is the Ceratus, the small African ship designed to, well, let's face it, make the Viper's lives a complete hell. Okay, sealed with point defense turrets, sealed those found on fight pods of Battlestars, so basically he has a lot of flak. Oh, it's tiny! Isn't it adorable? And as usual... there's a lot of them. Remember, this is a purely point... defense ship. So, Provost. I think I'm going to... right... there. So, let's see. Then, the mandatory base star of the group. Remember those strategies I used in the campaign of just... swarming the base stars with fighters? With these boys around, yeah, that wouldn't be a thing. Okay, wait, I can add more ships? Come on, really? Again, why not? Whatever, let's just add two revenants, just for firepower's sake. These guys are beastly. If left unchecked. I mean, those of you who saw the last boy, you saw how scared of them I was. And they did a lot of damage. Against, yeah, the colonial fleet are going to wreck them. Why can't I add more ships? I mean, granted, there's the... fine, I'll use one. And I'll add the Cerberus to the back, just for extra carrying power. Okay, and to match the name, Cylon Fleet 2. Now, let's put this up to proper standard. Base star with nukes, and heavy raiders. You. And the heavy raiders, the Cerberus with the regular raiders, and lots of them. And that's it, these guys don't carry fighters, so 6 wings of fighters in total. Okay, let's see. Going up with 2. Ready? Oh, I'm with the Cylons? Huh, interesting.
Prepare to jump in 3, 2, 1.
Oh no, okay, I'm the colonial. But that's the wrong... Sorry about that. Word. Just wanna quit it. Anyway, skirmish. Let's try this again. Eight, eliminate everybody. In the frontier. Cone of fleet number 2 versus where is it? Cylon fleet 2. Ready. Okay, let's try this again. Huh? Why does the sound almost cuts out midway? Well, it's a loading screen, so it's not really a problem, but still.
Prepare to jump in
3, 2, 1. Okay, let's see. Right in front of me. Okay.
Yes, Commander.
Start turning.
Yes, Commander.
Oops. Also, let me see. Huh. So, this is the colonial version of the Super Star Destroyer. It has a lot of firepower. Relatively speaking. Only when it's facing the enemy. Oh well, watch the carriers. Watch the carriers, watch the Vipers. Okay, there's everybody. Stay close though, remember. Well, I know what I'm up against. It doesn't come anywhere near my Vipers.
So say we all.
Well, let's just say I'll be picking scrap metal for a while. Okay, you guys stay in the back and provide long range fire support.
Yes, Commander.
Let's start boosting. You guys just use your regular drive to keep up. what do we have here?
Missiles incoming! So say we all.
And ship's almost collided.
Yes, sir.
Already. Well, this bodes well. They weren't kidding about the armor.
Yes, sir. Yes, Commander.
Okay, Vipers! Again, taking it like a champ and it barely tickles.
On it, Commander.
And that's Battlestar level armor right there. Then again, it's only one ship firing. I do remember more ships that had missiles, so why aren't they?
Centurions have boarded a Battlestar.
Oh, buddy, go for now. Stop boosting. Full defensive. You. Go back to normal. Get ready to fire. Okay.
Hostile unit identified. Centurions have boarded a Battlestar.
Again? Okay. That's bad.
Understood.
Okay. Well, I still can.
Understood.
Away. And you, nuke
it. So say we all.
And the other nuke goes... Oh, crap. Right there. Those are also nukes. Vipers! I got a job for you. Don't let me down. Okay. Now everybody, focus fire.
Unit identified.
Come on, come on. Okay, they're done.
Nuke incoming. Squadron has gone dark.
Okay, good. Yeah, I'd say this Jupiter is dead.
So say we all.
My Marines are dead. On the right side, of their firepower is gone. And squadron has gone dark. That was fast. Okay, now, focus fire on the bigger threats. Actually, don't. Torpedoes away.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you. I got no front armor. Okay, but of course I don't. Yeah, I'm out of Marines. These Battlestar is dead. And
yes,
he's
Commander.
He's back at me. Not your best move. On the bright side, both of the anti-fighter ships are dead, so...
Squadron target is confirmed.
Okay, carriers, focus fire. You two. They're going to destroy
Understood.
It. Destroy you, but... Well, they don't.
So say we all. So say we all.
Okay, good. And we'll get the rear disappear.
Commander.
That's one dead Jupiter class. Well, guess now we know what.
Yes, Commander.
What the Raptors are good for. Vipers will take care of him. The Battlestar is gonna die. There's nothing I can do about it. So...
On it, Commander.
Two are left.
Yes, Commander.
And the carriers are going to go at a base star and a Cerberus. That's actually kind of fun. And then again, they have no more missiles left, so there's that.
Yes, sir.
Shows how much they value her pilots. One, really. So much like that. Whatever.
Yes, sir.
Whoops. Okay. Full attack. Boosters off. Full attack.
Yes, Commander. Understood. On it, Commander.
Okay, Stim. Yes, it is good. Okay. I don't think that's necessary.
Centurions have boarded a Battlestar.
Even more? Ish! Get different ship at me. So, yeah. Time to watch the fireworks. And boom! number of ships it is really any one. Huh, already? Not bad.
On it, Commander.
May I should have used the Atlas.
Understood.
And then on that it was left to the surface. You know, I think demonstrating, but despite all of the people, all that talk about point of fists. The fact of the matter is...
Yes, Commander.
Well... You're gonna stop the nuke.
So say we all.
Also, these guys. It's interesting, but... Honestly, I think I prefer anatomies. I mean, it's a good... complete complementer, but... Nothing too major. And remember, these guys... actually survived to the second to be destroyed during the second Cybone War. If I'm not mistaken, you can see one of these guys in the Racer movie.
So say we all.
During Pegasus' escape,
yes,
from the shipyards. So yeah. Ooh. No, I don't think they would ever be used like I'm using it. And let's face it, the fleets in the war are probably a heck of a lot larger than this. I mean, 7 ships, that's a patrol fleet, that's not a war fleet. Torpedo barrels, try having your deck. sense, but I think you need a little more balance with the Corvettes. And it couldn't be up to destroying it. Maybe what for the gas missiles would be OP, but the battles don't happen. Anyway, people, this is a reinforcement map. Two ships for each faction. Now, would I recommend them? That's an interesting question. Oh, on a related note, yes, they are also in the campaign. Actually, allow me to show you. What I mean, you can purchase their blueprints and build them. At least if I'm not mistaken, you can the cruiser. There we are, the Genesis. The other ship is absent for some reason. Well, I suppose they figured no one would ever choose it over an adamant, so yeah, there's that. So it's odd. I mean, as you can see, it's right here, the cruiser, 3 missile points, silent style for some reason. Then it costs 410 to build, 4 turns. Now you can restart. You got new ships. Oh, so that's why. It's a starting ship. Oh, it complements. Not a bad idea. The Berserk carrier complementing the Adamant and the Manticore fleets. Actually, quite a good idea. But yeah, you can use them in a campaign if you want to. Personally, I'm thinking about starting it, but I won't do a let's play about it. I don't think the changes are significant enough to warrant it starting over. Also, you remember how the campaign was. The let's play is just me running away until the last part where I finally got the Battle Stars, the Jupiter class, and I could put up a proper fight. Anyway, people, this was my look at Battlestar Galactica Deadlock, the reinforcement pack. It costs $5, if I'm not mistaken, and should you get it? Actually, yeah, I'd say so, for $5. It's a reasonable price. You get some new toys to play even in the campaign, which for RTSs isn't all that common. Well, technically speaking, it's a 4X RTX in the campaign, so it is common. Anyway, details. Also, in my opinion, go buy it. It's worth the price. So many more ships and fleets to play with. The one thing I like is, I have 16,000 points. I mean, come on. These may cause performance issues. Use it at your own risk behind the 16,000. If people want to go crazy, let them. That's for developers. That's the only thing I want to add. And that the models are awesome, and actually some more shit for mothers to use, even though I'm fully aware you guys don't like it for some mysterious reason. Anyway, hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and well, you know the drill. Until next time, I've been the Six Dark King, and until then, I'll see you around. Ta-ta!